Well, happy Valentine's Day. That's coming up in just a couple of days. And so we hope that you enjoy that. If you have a special someone in your life, be sure to take them out. Gabe, are you ready for Valentine's Day?
Hey, thank you for reminding me, Brandon. I got to make a reservation at a restaurant real quick so that...
Well, we don't have time for that right now because we're talking about positive thoughts and happy relationships, but you better reserve that table if you want to have a happy Valentine's
Day. Well, you better tell my wife to have some positive thoughts today about after she knows that I forgot about making a reservation.
All right. Well, we'll see what happens. But let's talk about this idea of positive thinking or having a positive outlook on life. Gabe, do you tend to have more of a positive outlook or do you struggle with negative thoughts or a negative outlook?
Well, I think everybody struggles with negative thoughts sometimes, but in general, I have a more positive outlook on life.
Why do you think that is?
You know, there's a phrase that comes up in conversations sometimes with people that I use when maybe people are thinking negatively about somebody else and maybe gossiping or wanting to cast blame on somebody. Mm-hmm. And this phrase, to give someone the benefit of the doubt. For some reason, I always say that. Let's give that person the benefit of the doubt. And I always, or I'll at least say something about, hey, do you know all the details? Let's talk to this person. Let's see exactly what's going on. Because often we misinterpret a situation. And so that's one reason why we're negative is because we don't even understand the whole situation.
That is so true. We oftentimes are focusing on something that's not even correct, right? We're not thinking about it correctly. Well, when you struggle, Gabe, with negative thoughts, what helps you to switch to a more positive mindset?
Well, one thing that's helped me recently is the fact that I just hate bitter feelings. Like, I have in the past, when I think about somebody, have you ever imagined a conversation with somebody in your head? And it never actually happens, but you're thinking this conversation is just terrible and you hate the other person. And that's a form of bitterness, I think.
You're telling them what you really think.
Yeah, and I'm imagining these conversations in my head. They're not making me feel great. Right. And that feeling of bitterness, I just hate. So it's kind of like just a switch. I just stop thinking about that imaginary conversation.
That's good.
And that helps me to get back into a positive mood.
Absolutely. Well, we also talk about something that's called the 5-1 ratio for relationships. Mm-hmm. What do you think about this ratio? And do you find it helpful for your own marriage?
Yeah, I've never actually thought about it while my wife and I might have had some arguments or conflicts. I don't think about, am I making this a positive thing or a negative thing? Right. But I guess I could be more intentional about that. Generally, I think that our arguments don't last too long anyway. Mm-hmm. And I think for the most part, they do kind of end on a happier note or on a positive note.
All right. Well, that's a good place to be more positive than negative in your marriage or your other relationships. That's the goal. Well, enjoy your Valentine's Day. We'll see you next time here on Insights.